Okay, good evening. What to say, you know, thriller is going on. We are still making this group very, very hard and very tough until the last ball. From one side, that's good. From another side, I cannot be happy with the win like I will be. It is just 2 points more.
Trileris tęsiasi ir šioje grupėje viskas toliau vyksta labai atkakliai ir iki pat paskutinio kamuolio nebus aišku, kas pateks toliau.
We had a bad first half. When I speak about bad, I only watch the defense. We were not tough, hard. We didn't go to the man with the ball like we set the deal. Probably the importance of the game block up a little bit, couple of players. And from that game, we open a certain three-point night, three-point contest in the first half. They slowed us down, and we miss a lot of open shots in the zone. We didn't make a balance between inside and outside game against zone.
Buvo blogas, pirma rungtynių dalis buvo bloga, ir aš kai kalbu bloga, tai turiu omenyje gynybą. Nesiginėme. Neginėme žmonių su kamuoliu taip arti, kaip buvome tarėsi, ir visą tai pavirto į tritaškių konkursą. O mes patys kažkaip neradom balanso tarp žaidimo po krepšiu ir ties tritaškio linija.
We let them to run up game with too many players inside. So a lot of their players coming from the bench or starters in the game feel the game comfortable and feel the game confident by scoring first shots.
Mes leidome pataikyti daug metimų jiems žaidėjams, kurie įeina iš nuosuolo ir pajunta iškart pasitikėjimą savimi, pataikė iškart savo pirmą metimą.
And confirmation for that is a 7 foul just in 20 minutes. That's not who we are.
7?
7 fouls in the first half.
Ir mes tik tai 7 baudas per 20 minučių pirmas surinkome. Tai ne tokia mes esame iš tikrųjų komanda.
Second half we are stronger. We play, I can say, a bit better in a defense, but I think from my state of point the game was not sold before, and we didn't go up because in a two or three situations in the second half and a two and a three situations also in the first half, after a really hard work in a defense, after chasing minus from 10 to 2 and again for 2-6 and then up, we were 2-3 times a chance to go in a lead or to make our advantage bigger for 2 points. We make a simple passes and a fast break in their hands. With too much, I think 4 or 5, maybe 6 turnovers were just a simple passing, not good solution, and we let them run the game still.
Antrojo rungtynių dalyje žaidėme geriau, bet buvo momentų, kai kelis kartus, o tiksliau 2-3 kartus pirmoje rungtynių dalyje ir antroje rungtynių dalyje suklysdavome labai elementariuose dalykose, kaip perduodami kamuolį, ir tokios gal 5 ar 6 klaidos, vietoj to, kad mes išsiverštume į priekį ar sumažinome skirtumą, mes atiduodame kamuolį į jų rankas ir taip vis neišsiverždavome į priekį.
So, a little bit shorter we are in rotation, that's one fact, so we miss a bit of rotation since we have injured players, but I can say that overall I'm really happy that we didn't retreat, we didn't surrender. For that we get award these 3 points, and for that we didn't get award that we are still inside our group for qualifying to top 8, where I think we deserve to play, and we're going to do everything to do that.
Faktas yra tas, kad mūsų atsarginių žaidėjų suolelis yra trumpesnis, bet aš džiaugiuosi, kad mes šiandien nepasidavėme ir laimėjome rungtynes, ir toliau tęsėme kovą dėl patekimo į top 8, ir manau, kad mes ten turėtume būti, nusipelnėme būti.
That's all from my side.
Prašau klausimą.
Didžiojo rungtynių dalį Lietuvos rytas spaudė varžovus visoje aikštėje, nepaisant to, kad atsarginių žaidėjų suolelis Lietuvos ryto trumpas, daug traumuotų žaidėjų, ar tai pasiteisino, gal pritrūko paskui jėgų ginantis, varžovai dažnai metė laisvi.
Well, you started the game and try to push, to do pressing in defense a lot, even though their rotation is short. So maybe, you know, at the end, just not enough power in the players.
Yeah, but that's what we have, you know. You cannot run, you know. We wanted to run the game, we are running, you know. We are playing the same way, and we are just adjusting to some things, you know. That's push-up defense, give us those, at least those 3 points on the end. We were not reacting good on the first passes, you know. A couple of times we slip, we put the ball in front of us, we are not running good back. We are not closing out. We make a couple of mistakes in a simple switchings of man-to-man to a zone. A couple of times we didn't react good. So I think that with slow game, with something like this, we cannot play Ulker, you know, because they are the team who is running the game also very fast, you know. At least we must go, for my state of point, what was the goal of this game is to try to push, but we make a deal and we're supposed to be a bit smarter in the offense. When I say a bit smarter in the offense, is couple of offenses we shoot too fast, too soon, and couple of offenses we make those turnovers. So reducing those fast shots and reducing those turnovers, at least for, I can say, 30%, I'm sure that the result is going to be different. But that's, theoretically, it's easy to speak now. Rotation is shorter like it is. I don't think that we suffer that much in the kind of game we are running, you know. So we are doing the best we can in this moment.
Prieš Fenerbahčę negali laimėti žaisdamas lietai, dėl to, kad yra komanda labai greita ir mes spausdami varžovus bent jau tuos 3 taškus gavome. Teoriškai labai dabar paprasta kalbėti, taip, mūsų rotacija trumpesnė, bet esmė ne tame buvo. Esmė, kad puolime mes kartais perskubėdavome mesti arba nesureaguodavome pirmą perdavimą laiku ir sklysdavome.
Profile of our players is not to run that game. Also not to forget to say one big thank you, and I really mean it. It's not like courtoisie. It's not like behaving like pleasant, like just a sentence. I want to say a really big thank you to this crowd tonight, you know, because they were carrying us away to the end, you know. It's just something which is impressive, you know, and I really enjoy to play in front of this crowd and in this gym.
Aš tik noriu pasakyti, ne tik tam, kad pasakyčiau, bet iš tikrųjų šiandien publika mus vedė iki pat pabaigos ir aš žiauriai laimingas, kad galiu žaisti prieš tokius žiūrovus.
Yeah, one of the biggest motive to go to Final Eight, except of everything what Final Eight brings, you know, is to play at least one more game in the EuroLeague here.
Ir viena didžiausia motivacijų patekti į kitą etapą yra tam, kad sužaistume dar bent kartą šitoje arenoje. Do you believe that Tau Ceramica is going to play with full strength, even though for them the game doesn't
matter? Do I have a choice?
Ar aš turiu
pasirinkimą? Even if I don't believe, I will believe.
Net jeigu netikiu, vis tiek
turiu tikėti. No, I don't know. They are quality team, they are first spotted, they can do whatever you want. They want, you know, we're going to go to try to play the best game we can and try to win, you know. So, if something goes the other way, good. Now, we are in a bit situation. We are generally choosing in this stage of 16. I'm always telling to my players that it's easy and hard way, you know. We choose the most hardest way this moment. I think that we deserve one win of those two road games. Probably you watch on a TV. I was not satisfied with the treatment, you know, but that's the game. That's the part of the game. That's the part of the EuroLeague game. And we are just a part, we must play the best we can. So, I will believe that we go in Saloniki to play our game. Quality is on the side of Tau Ceramica. And what we can do.
Aš visada savo žaidėjams sakau, kad yra du keliai, yra lengvas ir sunkus. Ir mes dabar einame tuo sunkiuoju keliu. Ir pažiūrėjusite įrašus rungtynių, bent tas porą išvykų, bent vienas iš jų turėjome laimėti. Nebuvo labai patenkintas taip, kaip mes buvome kai kuriais sprendimais. Dabar, ką, Tau Ceramica yra gera komanda, o mes galime laimėti išvykoje, todėl žiūrėsime. What is the situation now with
Petravičius and Nilsen? Petravičius surely gonna have a checkout practice in a Friday.
Petravičius tikrai jau treniruosis penktainį
to see in which kind of state he is, he will start to run.
If
that confirmation is going to be okay, if the checkout is going to be okay, probably Monday he will have another one, some certain drills to see how he's reacting on those things. If that is okay, he's going to join us. About Matt, we must take care a little bit more, so I accept him maybe. I wait for him, maybe I can say in a most positive way a week later.
Tai jeigu penktadienį Petravičiui po bėgimo viskas bus gerai, tada pirmadienį jisai dar pabandys sudalyvauti treniruotėje kažkokius derinius atliekant. Ir jeigu viskas gerai, jisai turėtų prisijungti prie komandos jau kitą savaitę. O dėl Nielseno reikia šiek tiek atsargiau, todėl realiau, kad po savaitės pažiūrėsime.